Hi guys, Dr. Charles Chabert, urologist and director of the Prostate Clinic. Trying to navigate treatment choices for a diagnosis of localized prostate cancer can be a bit of a nightmare. Once you jump online, you'll realize that there are an array of different treatment choices that range from various forms of surgery, different types of radiation treatment, and there are some novel or experimental treatment options where we either heat the prostate, freeze the prostate, or pass electricity through various parts of the prostate with a view to effecting cure. One size does not fit all, and there are, without question, nuances to the different treatment choices that are applicable for different types of disease, different shapes and sizes of prostates, and different individual characteristics that we as men all have. In this video specifically, we're going to explore surgery, which is called a radical prostatectomy. So a quick bit of revision with regard to some of the anatomy down in the pelvis. We have the bladder on top. Below the bladder is the prostate. At the back of the prostate are these structures, of which there are two. They're called the seminal vesicles. They're a reservoir for ejaculatory fluid. This is the pubis or the pelvic bone. So a radical prostatectomy can be performed in lots of different ways. It can be done traditionally in an open surgery, performed robotically, which is a type of keyhole surgery. The aim of a radical prostatectomy is to completely remove the prostate together with the seminal vesicles to effect cure from prostate cancer. Because of the location of the prostate, which in essence is deep within the pelvis and it's sandwiched really in between the base of the bladder and the pelvic floor, behind the prostate is the terminal part of the bowel or the rectum. And because of these crucial structures that are close by the prostate, there are certain aspects from a functional perspective that people need to be aware of when looking at their treatment choices. In our previous video, we've discussed some of the key aspects that you need to be aware of when it comes to understanding prostate cancer, namely the Gleason score, the PSA, and how the prostate feels. If you haven't watched that video, please find the link at the end of this video. And when we look at treatment choices for prostate cancer, there are three outcome measures that are crucial. They look at the likelihood of curing the cancer, or oncological efficacy, and we look at functional outcomes. Now, from a functional perspective, there are two key areas of concern. One is from a urinary point of view, and the second one is from a sexual function perspective. If we look at outcomes from a cancer point of view, ultimately that will depend upon your cancer characteristics. Every individual following this surgery, or every individual with a prostate cancer diagnosis, has their own individual blueprint of what type of prostate cancer that they have. We make decisions from a treatment perspective on the basis of clinical features, but following surgery, we get more definitive answers because we have pathological features. At the lab, they tell us what type of cancer. In particular, what was the Gleason score? Now, the thing to be aware of with a Gleason score is it can change from biopsy through to the final pathology. And the risk of change is about 10 to 15%. Now, you may say to me, how can that happen? In essence, what it is a byproduct of sampling error, which means that when you have a biopsy, a needle is placed into the prostate several times to get a sample of someone's tumor. When someone has surgery to remove their prostate, we have the ability to look at the entire prostate and the tumor in its entirety, and so we get a better handle on the specifics with regards to the Gleason score. In addition to that, we determine how big or how small a particular tumor is. Is it within the prostate or is it grown to the shell? And the margins, the resection margins, are they clear of cancer? And the resection margin really refers to whether or not there is a cancer cell at the edge when we've removed the prostate. The more aggressive features there are to a tumor, the greater the risk of recurrence. And if we have recurrence, there is a greater requirement for needing additional treatment. Okay, let's have a little look at some of the functional aspects. Please, if you haven't already, if you're enjoying this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed to our channel, please do subscribe, switch on the notifications so you're kept up to date with all things with regards men's health. Now, when we remove the prostate, the pelvic floor itself does become a little bit bruised. And also the anastomosis, or the join between the bladder and the outlet pipe, causes that muscle not to work as well as it currently does in the immediate post-operative period. In that recovery phase, the majority of men do experience some urinary incontinence. And for the majority of men, it usually takes around 3 to 4 months. Some men, it can be a little bit slower, and there are some risk factors that will slow down an individual's recovery. They do include carrying excess weight, being an older man, or having a large prostate, or alternatively, more aggressive cancer features. Those characteristics do increase the risk that you will experience a slower return of urinary control. Okay, if we look at sexual function, well, sexual function really is two things. It's ejaculation and also it's erectile function. Now, ejaculatory function, as I alluded to beforehand, just about all of the fluid that a man sees when he ejaculates comes from the prostate and the seminal vesicles. We remove those structures, so there will be no emission of fluid should a man have an orgasm after surgery. Erectile function, however, is dependent upon a few different criteria, but from an anatomical point of view, there needs to be intact neurovascular bundles. In essence, that is the nerve and the vascular supply to the penis. If a man has good erectile function before surgery and the disease profile, the cancer characteristics, mean that it is safe to preserve those nerves, then that man has a reasonably high chance of erectile function recovery. However, important thing to be aware of, it takes time, and it usually takes about a year to a year and a half for men to fully regain erectile function. Okay, so there you have it. There's an introduction into radical prostatectomy, which is a surgical treatment for the management of localized prostate cancer. The issues, again, to summarize, that we've discussed relate to our ability to cure cancer with this approach and the functional issues that you need to be aware of before selecting this treatment. I hope this video helps and answers some of your questions. If you do have more, however, please leave them in the comment box below. Don't forget to subscribe, give this video a thumbs up, and switch on your notifications to be up to date with all things related to men's health. Thanks again.